just like I would talk about something in specific, my baby brother's passing or like my trauma as a child, and I would start like disassociating, and my therapist recognized it with me, where I like everything starts going blurry, like I'll start talking and everything starts going blurry, and my therapist says that that's disassociating, and I've worked on ways to like help with it, but I just disassociated as I was talking to you guys. If you guys saw me like looking off, that was crazy. Had to bring myself back, but yeah, so last week was a hard week, but this week we are back to recording and responsibilities. So I am starting therapy today. I'm really excited. I'm gonna go and see my new therapist, which I'm actually really just nervous about, because I feel like starting with a new therapist, it's like I have to retell her everything about my life, and so I was like gonna write, I was gonna sit down and write down like everything that I'm gonna talk to her about, and then I was like, hold on, Kiera, I can ease into it, like how about we just go to today's session and just talk, she can just get to know me a little bit. I feel like I always have to plan for everything. Sometimes it's okay to just, you know, go and do something without, it's like my anxiety preparing me, which I think my anxiety, it keeps me safe, so but yeah, so I'm really excited to start therapy again. I feel like I need it. I have gone without it for since July, so August, September, so 2 months now, and it's been, honestly, I've been doing okay, but I feel like I definitely need to get back into it. I would go weekly, and it was just so beneficial for my mental health, so I feel like in order to get my mental health back on track, I need to go and, you know, establish a new therapist. I'm really, really, really excited. I've been having these moments where I just don't want to do anything, you guys, and they're coming back, and I don't know if it's burnout or if it is just procrastination or laziness. Like, I never know how to like differentiate between the between them. I don't know how to see if it's like me just being lazy or burnout of me not wanting to do anything. I'm not a lazy person. I like to always be productive. I like to always be doing something, so I don't think it's laziness. Maybe procrastination. I get very stressed out when I'm go, go, go. So maybe my body is kind of, you know, preventing me from getting stressed out. I like to always like dig deep in my feelings and my emotions. That's what my therapist says is good for me. My old therapist says it's good to do that. So I don't even know why, but anyway, I wanted to talk to you guys in this video for those who are struggling. I know I'm just going on with my own rambles, but that's what the podcast is here for, right? Sometimes we just need to ramble. But I wanted to talk to you guys, specifically who are struggling right now. I feel like most of the time people struggle alone because we feel like, or a lot of people, because we feel like no one else knows what we're going through, or no one, there's nothing anyone can do to like help with whatever we're struggling with, you know? And I've learned that that is wrong. Because for me, before I went to therapy, it was like, I just felt like I'm always gonna have my trauma. Like, it's always gonna be here. I'm always just gonna be the way I am because of what I went through growing up. And I just always, like, that was my reality. This is just who I am. This is just how I am. And after I went to therapy, it's like, she understood me. Like, she understood what I was saying and everything I said. And when I would, like, you know, explain what I'm feeling, she'd be like, oh yeah, well that's 'cause this. Oh yeah, 'cause that's 'cause this. And it, like, helped me realize that our emotions are so important and they are so valid. Like, every reaction has a reaction. Okay, well, every emotion is because of something that's happened maybe in your past that just happened to trigger to something that your body remembers in your past, whatever. But your sadness is valid. Your hurting is valid. And I know it's hard and I know it sucks. See on social media, it's not